Hey everyone, Marine here for Learn Fun. I'm so happy to be back with a new interactive card featuring the brand new Magic Iris die set, as well as some cute images from previous releases. Today, the spring release is finally available, and I'm curious to know which stamp and die sets do you prefer? So like I said, it's an interactive card, and this new Magic Iris die might be a little bit impressive and not easy to use, but you're going to see that it's the opposite, super easy and quick to build. Like always, all the supplies I will use are listed down below the video. I started by die cutting all my pieces. I have 3 rings, 3 sausage or balloon pieces that I cut out of vellum, 3 stabilizers, and 1 tab. The first thing to do is to take one of the rings and to use this die. This die is round shaped, so it's easy to align it right in the center of the ring. So you align the die and you send the element to your die cutting machine. And this is what we get. We have 3 slots and 3 stitch brackets that will be very useful later. Next, I take 1 sausage, I put the small tab into a slot, and I align the curve of the sausage with the curve of the ring. And I used washi tape to temporarily keep everything in place. And next, I'm going to repeat the same process. I take a sausage piece, put the small tab into the next slot, and I align the curve of the sausage with the curve of the ring. The sausage die will create an X mark on your elements. This is where you need to add adhesive, and the best adhesive to use is 3/16 of an inch or 5 mm glue dots. So you take 1 glue dot and you attach it on the X mark, and you repeat this for the 2 other X marks. Next, you take another ring, you align it on top of the sausages, and you press down to adhere that ring on the 3 glue dots. Next, I remove the washi tape that was keeping the first ring and sausages together. I make sure everything is aligned, and I add washi tape again to keep my first and second rings together. Next, you flip the ring over and you can see the 3 stitch brackets. These are going to guide you to adhere the stabilizers. You need to add double-sided tape right on those bracket spots, from the inside of the ring to the outside of the ring. You removed the backing paper, and next you can attach the stabilizers on the 3 bracket spots. I didn't adhere my stabilizers right up against the inside curve of the ring, but you definitely can. Next, we can flip the ring over and we're going to attach the tab next to one of the stabilizers. You pick the stabilizer you want. You add double-sided tape at the back of the tab. And you want to stick it next to the stabilizers, following the inside curve of the ring and making like a V shape. Next, you need to add double-sided tape to the 3 stabilizers. You remove the backing paper and the washi tape if you used some. you place the last ring on top of the element, and you fold the stabilizers to attach them on the ring. Be careful, you don't want it to be too tight or the mechanism won't work. You need to gently hug the stabilizers around the ring so everything can work perfectly. And now the magic iris is done and you can already see how cool it's going to be. Next, I'm going to create the inside of my washing machine. And to do so, I'm simply tracing the inside circle of my magic iris on the Nina Solar white panel. I did the stamping of screen using the lovely Little Bundle stamp set and jet black ink. Next, I erase the pencil line. And next, I can color the images using my alcohol markers in blue shades. I didn't want the background to be white, so I quickly masked the images and used a light blue marker to stay consistent with my blue theme. Also, I'm using a white gel pen to add some details, such as white highlights on the images and white dots on the blue background to give the illusion of tiny soap bubbles. Next, I placed the magic iris ring on my colored panel and traced all around it. I cut the circle. And next, I'm going to stick the ring on the circle. And to do so, I apply double-sided tape on the three stabilizers. I peel the backing paper off. And then I can adhere the ring onto the circle. And now see how fun this is. Next, I apply liquid glue at the back of the ring. I cut a 5.5 by 4.25 inches stitched panel, as well as a light blue panel that I cut using the cover plate die from the add-on die set. I put the ring behind the light blue panel, making sure to align both the circle in the middle and the tab at the top right hand corner. And next I can press down onto the dark blue panel to adhere the ring. I also needed some extra pieces to build my little scene. I cut the floor out of white wood grain cardstock and I cut the baseboard out of faux cardstock using a die from the picket fence border die set. And I attached those two pieces at the bottom of my light blue panel to have a nice and clean floor. Next, I applied foam tape around the magic iris ring, making sure not to touch it. And now I can adhere the front panel to hide the mechanism. I'm sorry I'm out of frame here, but I really had to see the card very closely to be able to align the light blue panel perfectly. To totally complete the Magic Iris, I cut the hero out of 4 cardstock using a die from the Magic Iris main die set, and I glued this piece on the tab. I stamped and colored additional images from the Loads of Fun stamp set, and I created an opening on the washing machine using a circle die from my stash. And I don't know about you, but my washing machine has a nice silver frame around the door, so I cut a silver stitched frame that I'm going to attach on the machine. And I think it adds a very cool detail to the scene. Now I can finally attach my images, starting with the washing machine and using foam squares. My sentiment will be in two parts. On the top left corner, I'm stamping a little bundle using black ink. I'm adding 3 little dots after those 3 words. And for the second part, I stamp the words "is on the way" on mermaid cardstock using clear embossing ink. I apply white embossing powder on the ink. And then I melt the powder using my heat tool. And to fit on the bottom right corner, I'm going to cut this part of the sentiment using a die from the Everyday Sentiment Banner die set. I trim this banner a little bit and I'm going to attach it on my panel using foam squares. And finally, for a last touch of cuteness, I'm adding a few iridescent drops here and there. Now it looks like soap bubbles are floating in the air. And it's all done. So what do you think about this new Magic Iris die set? I hope this card inspires you, and I can't wait to use this die on other projects. Thank you so much for watching. See you very soon. Bye!